Почитувани гледачи, не само поединци, туку и цели држави и народи се препознаваат по своите дела, кои се забележуваат низ вековите и се пренесуваат доколку се тоа добри дела на идните генерации. Затоа е толку многу важно како секој од нас живее и како сите ние колективно, како народ живееме, за да допринесеме за добробитта на нашите држави, а со тоа и на целиот свет и на сите идни поколенија. Денес разговараме токму на оваа тема со неговата екселенција, господинот Мирослав Томан, амбасадор на Чешката Република во Република Македонија, за што искрено се заблагодаруваме. Господине Томан, ве молам да се навратиме на едно далечно време по повод јубилејот 100 години од основањето на Чехословачка. Станува збор за далечната 1918 година за 28. октомври, кога всушност се основа Чехословачка врз руините на Австро-Унгарското царство. Кои се клучните политички личности на основањето на Чехословачка од тоа време, кои се героите на вашата Чехословачка?
Добр ден, good afternoon, Madam Kostovska, it's a pleasure to be here with you. And thank you very much for inviting me for this discussion. If you are asking me about the main historical persons responsible for the independence of the Czechoslovakia that you mentioned was established in 1918, of course I have to name at least three of those. First would be the first president of the Czechoslovakia, Tomáš Garrigue Masaryk, who established the resistance against the Austro-Hungary in Switzerland, and he became, of course, the first president after the Czech Republic was established. His closest friend, person, and helper, Edvard Beneš, who became the Minister of Foreign Affairs, and also the president in 1935, when the president Masaryk resigned from his position. And as the unofficial representative of Slovakia, it was Mr. Štefanik, who was a politologist, pilot, general in the French army, who became Minister of War by that time. And those three people are celebrated, and we are grateful to them for establishing of the Czech Republic, as you mentioned, November 28, 1918. When the National Council agreed on the establishment of the Czech Republic on the 28th of October, then Karel Kramář, who was the Prime Minister instead of the position that was held by the President Masaryk. So we had four persons in the government at the beginning, and we are grateful to them for the establishment of the Czechoslovakia by that time.
Се не враќаме сега на вашиот јубилеј, кој го прославувате оваа година, 100 години од основањето на Чехословачка. И ве молам, кажете ни, како се случи разидувањето на Чехословачка и како понатаму се развива односите помеѓу двете држави?
Well, it happens. We have lived together more than 70 years in one state, during the good time and the bad time also. But at the end, in 1992, after the election, the politicians has decided to create two states, Czech Republic and Slovak Republic, and it happened from the 1st January 1993. This decision was made by the politicians, even though I would say that most of the people by that time would not agree with that decision. So it turned out as probably the best decision that could have been done, because since then we have two states, but the relationship between two states was never better than before, like it is today. And I must say that this time we consider Slovaks still as our brothers. We have met again in the European Union and NATO, and they are our closest friends in Europe and in all over the world. So divorce might happen, but that was a very peaceful divorce, and we are still brothers, and we cooperate very much together.
To je ohrabruvačka poraka za mnogo državi i narodi. Za diplomatskite i kulturni relacije pomeđu našte dve države će govorime malku podocna. No, za svega bi ve zamolila da porazgovarame za sito ona pošto je prepoznatljiva Češka Republika. Ona ima duri 12 mesta koji se nalistata na svetski znamenitosti koji se pod zaštita na UNESCO, među koje je i prekrasna ta Praga.
Yes, almost everybody knows Prague and everybody would like to go to Prague, I hope, and I recommend. That's true. Czech Republic and Prague itself is full of cultural attractions with its Prague Castle as the dominant of the hill up to the river Vltava. I think that people has heard already about Charles Bridge, Charles University, and in Prague it's very easy to go through and see the spirit from the past coming from the 14th century when Charles IV was the Czech king and Roman emperor, and to see lots of modern stuff that were finished just quite recently. But it would be very difficult to describe it to the people. I would rather recommend to everybody to go there and see, because in the World Traveler for the 2016, Prague was rated as the fifth best city to travel to, and it was rated as the fifth most visited city in Europe after London, Paris, Istanbul and Rome. So this is definitely the destination that anybody shouldn't miss.
Može bi tukmu zato deneska se sluša i malku poinakva sintagma deka site patišta vodat vo Praga. Slovenskite kulturi se neraskidljivo povrzani, a posebno kulturite pomeđu Makedonija i Češka Republika. Poradi golemata Moravska misija vo 863. godina na osnovu položnicite na slovenskata pismenost solunskite braća Sveti Kiril i Metodi. 2013. godina, kako što je poznato, beše proglasena od strana UNESCO kako godina posvetena na ovije svetitelji. Kako češki od narod gi doživuva Sveti Kiril i Metodi? Koji manifestaciji, koji aktivnosti i obeležja postoje u vaša država?
Yes, Kiril and Methodius are very well known in the Czech Republic and in the former Czechoslovakia, and definitely even for our Slovak brothers, as I mentioned already. This year we have celebrated 1155th anniversary from the time that came together to the Great Moravia, and that was actually the first time when somebody collected the Slavonian language, and they issued the books, the religious books for the people in the language that actually everybody could understand. So I must say that by that time, our language or our languages were much closer to each other than today. But going back to the Cyril and Methodios brothers, we consider them as, and they also were pronounced as patrons of Europe by the Pope John Paul II. And in the Czech Republic, we have lots of things that bring us to remember them, at least at the Prague Castle, for example, at the church that is named after Cyril and Methodios in Prague. So we have lots of statues and sculptures of Cyril and Methodios in the Czech Republic. The main known is probably that one at the Charles Bridge in Prague. And we also celebrate every year on the July 5th, which is the state holiday and non-working day, big gathering in Velehrad.
Историјата има и многу други настани со кои се поврзани нашите две држави низ вековите. Не можеме да ги опфатиме сите, но сепак кажете ни за некои најзначајни од нив.
It's a group of Sokol that had been created in 19th century in the Czech Republic, and if I'm not mistaken, in 1902 in Kumanovo and 1910 in Tetovo also. And I was told that in 1928 groups of those sport persons came to the Czech Republic for the big all over the world gathering of Sokol, and they brought something that you use till today, which is the greeting Zdravo. It's supposed to be coming from the Czech expression Nazdar that was used during those Sokol gatherings at the beginning and at the end of these meetings of people. So I believe that it's quite close, and I'm telling everybody that this comes from the Czech word. So another thing that I might point out in the past is establishment and creation of the Skopska pivara, beer in Skopje, that was built and created by the Czech engineers and with the Czech capital between two world wars. And we still have it today. And you can remind everybody that this is kind of a Czech type of beer that we are drinking in Skopje. One thing that people might be passing every day and don't know the background might be mentioned by myself in this regard. Behind the parliament, Subranje, there is a monument of Robert Gajdík. This is the young guy that was assassinated by the Nazis during the World War II. And not many people know that that was the guy that came from Prague to Skopje on bicycle to see his father, who was working with the Matka then by that time. So also Czech people and Czech engineers were helping to build up the dam that everybody knows today. So I think that those two examples are quite significant to describe the ties between Czechoslovakia and Macedonia in the past. And also we have a good and enough things for today and for the future, I hope.
Кога станува збор за едукацијата, од кога македонскиот јазик се изучува во Чешката република и обратно, од кога чешкиот јазик е присутен на нашиот универзитет, како и другите настани и манифестации на овој план, ве молам споделите ги со нашите гледачи.
First time the subject of the Czech language started to be taught in UKIM, in the university in Skopje, in the school year of 1946 and 47. Since then, the Macedonian language is a subject in right now Masaryk University in Brno, and Czech language is part of the philological faculty of the UKIM here. Czech embassy and all my colleagues and people in the Czech Republic would like to keep this tradition. So there is the exchange of the lectors. The Macedonian lector teaches at the Masaryk University in Brno, and we always have one lector coming from the Czech Republic to learn Czech language. Young people interested in this language. We succeeded in providing the scholarship for 5 students that will be interested in studying Czech language from this coming year, when the tuition will be paid by the South Moravian region, because Brno, as I mentioned, and Masaryk University, Brno is the main city of the South Moravian region. We succeeded in getting the scholarships for Macedonian people for the Czech language here. And we hope that we will see more and more interested young people getting the Czech language, and of course, you know, studying language here and using the exchange programs that we have for the summer schools when Czech people are coming over here to Ohrid mostly, and Macedonians to Brno and Plzeň for the studying during the summer holidays.
Привет!
Ahoj!
Салам алейкум!
Ahoj!
Всем привет!
Hey!
Во меморијата на македонскиот народ секогаш ќе остане забележана големата благодарност за приемот и гостопримливоста на македонците од Егејска Македонија, што им беше пружена во 40-тите години од страна на чешкиот народ, за што ја користам и оваа пригода уште еднаш да се заблагодарам.
Yes, Aegean Macedonians were coming to the former Czechoslovakia after Second World War, and it was mostly children that lost the parents or fully orphans, and the number is said to be up to 14,000 of those. So we have people that stay in the Czech Republic and former Czechoslovakia, and they are still there. And we also have people that were returning to Macedonia, for example. So we have lots of people here that have roots in the Czech Republic. For those people that I describe, you know, they had families, they had children, and when they moved back, we have lots of people that actually were born in the Czech Republic, speak the language, and they are living in Macedonia. And great example I can use is that if I need anybody as a local staff at the embassy, I will always find somebody who speaks very well Czech, because either he was born in the Czech Republic or he or she does have sometimes ties with people in the Czech Republic. The target for the Czech embassy is to keep in touch with these people, of course, and to bring them to the embassy and to the Czech Republic right now. But not only with those people, but also with some Czechs that are living in Macedonia, who entered here and are having families and stay here. So that's why we started to cooperate much closely with the group that is called Group of Macedonia and Czech Republic Friendship, that was established 10 years ago in Bitola, and we are trying to bring them closer to us, and of course to be more in touch with the people that like the Czech Republic, they have something to do in the Czech Republic, and we will be more and more focused on them and cooperate with them on various issues, not only with some cultural events, but also to help us to promote more the Czech business and people coming to Macedonia.
Уште една голема солидарност и помош од Чешката република беше изразена за време на земјотресот во Скопје во 1963 година. Да подсетиме што тогаш вашата држава стори за Скопје.
Yes, first of all, we were not the only one who helped Skopje after the terrible earthquake in 1963, but we were among those who contributed, I would say, quite a lot by that time, and it's still seen and visible. Of course, there are not so not anymore those houses that were built by the Czechs and donated by the Czech government. We had like 60 houses and 70 flats by that time that were built from the Czech donation. But we still have Prague Street that belongs to that era in Karpoš where those houses used to be. We still have a school there, which is called after the Czech teacher of nations, Jan Amos Komenský, that was built after the earthquake by the Czech money and with the Czech engineers. Unfortunately, it got a fire later on, but after it was rebuilt, the Czech Republic again contributed with some equipment of the school, with the furniture for the children and with other stuff. And we still keep in touch with the school, with the principal. We organize some exhibition in the school because we think that the children should know actually who is the person that the name of the school is named after. So this is one of the things that we still keep alive, and we are in very good touch with the school. Last time I was there in the spring, and we were planting a tree in the Park of Friendship. So Czech Republic does have, if I'm not mistaken, the biggest one right now.
Има уште еден момент кој е мощно значаен во соработката помеѓу двете држави, а се однесува на соработката на регионален и локален план. Што се случува на овој план?
So for now we were able to bring together two cities that are in the logic that we have, because I have already mentioned, you know, the Masaryk University and the South Moravian region in the Czech Republic. So we brought together the city of Skopje and the city of Brno, the second largest city in the Czech Republic, and we got the agreement on both sides that they will establish the partnership and they will establish themselves as twin cities. So after the agreement is signed, I assume that we will see more and more events that will be done by these municipalities here in Skopje or there in Brno. We will see hopefully a robust cultural exchange. We will see sharing of the experience, let's say, within the transportation system that is used in Brno, that might be introduced here, and lots of other things that might bring the advantage of cooperation between two cities. Hopefully it will be successful, and we wish it's for a long, long time.
Во доменот на поддршката на реформите, посебно се значени локалните проекти, меѓу кои се и оние за децата. Во што тие се состојат?
Czech embassy every year choose one from one to three projects that we are trying to support those regional authorities. In the last year we have already helped for example, Starona Goričane, Tetovo, even Skopje. Usually we send some donation for the rebuilding of schools and places where that's are for children. For this year we have chosen the project in Klečovce, near to Kumanovo, where we will rebuild or renovate the current school, so the pupils, the children, will have better conditions to go to school, and hopefully he will be having a better environment and better feeling from the school that will be almost new. So those are the projects that we, as the Czech Republic and the Czech Embassy, support from the money that we are getting from our country.
Кога станува збор за хуманитарната помош, посебно е значајна помошта која што вашата држава ја даде по поплавите во 2016 година во Македонија, а исто така и за време на миграционата криза. Колку што ми е познато, станува збор за исклучителна помош и за големи буџети.
We couldn't stay apart after the terrible flood in 2016, so we tried to contribute as much we could. I think or I know that we brought almost 45 big pumps for water and mud that were used and given to those people who needed them. We brought some electrical centrals that were helping, you know, in the areas where the electricity was not functioning. We have brought the help that was in 10,000 of euros value by that time. For the second question regarding the migration crisis that happened in 2015, so I must say that the Czech Republic was among those leading countries that agreed to help Macedonia to stop it. Since then, we have more than 700 policemen, Czech policemen, that serve in southern border together with Macedonian police. And it will take at least till the end of this October. After that we will see, because there are some other agreements that the Macedonian government is preparing, so we are not certain yet, but I would like to stress that the Czech contingent in Macedonia of the police that helping at the border areas is the biggest from all the other countries. We have also sent more than 3 million euros as a donation to the Ministry of Interior and mostly to the border police of Macedonia. And that's why you can see lots of policemen using Czech cars that were bought from this donation. And I'm proud that this year I had the chance to sign the third in the row donation that we signed together with the Minister Spasovsky. And again, for those money, the equipment for the police and especially border police will be delivered as soon as possible. So I think that the Czech Republic is among those who is very much visible in these areas.
Ekonomskata saradnja je suštinski važna za obe te države. Kako ta se odbiva dosega i gledate li može napredak u određenoj oblasti?
Economic cooperation is not as good as it could be, if I may put it so. I think that it might be much better because of all the ties that I have already described. You know, to develop this economic cooperation, we try to do some projects that the embassy is promoting. Recently we had a seminar for almost 500 farmers where we introduced Czech agricultural companies to them and what they might be doing together or how they can be supplying each other.
Vo prepoznatljivi belezi na Češkata Republika se i proizvodite so koji ta je konkurentna na svetski od pazar. Za koji proizvodi stanova zbor?
I think it would be a quite a long list, but I have already mentioned some of those. First of all, I was very surprised when I came to Macedonia and I have seen so many Škoda cars on the street and roads. And when I talked to the dealership, so they told me that if they would be able to bring more, they would even sell more. So this is definitely one of the articles that everybody in Macedonia knows. And I am proud of that, to see and know that the Czech Republic, a young country that we said at the beginning, is able to produce such a reliable cars that are able to compete with all the others all over the world. Among others, people might know a well-known Czech porcelain and glass, and this is always, you know, the article that the tourists and visitors are looking for back in various cities in the Czech Republic, because especially the design is quite different and the clear cut of the glass is quite different from the others. I cannot go without mentioning beer, of course, because the Czech Republic is the biggest consumer of beer all over the world, but it's also a biggest producer, one of the biggest producer to be correct. Czech Republic probably did not give the beer to the world, but it's a mark. So those are things that people all over the world, and I'm sure here in Macedonia, knows about the Czech products and Czech Republic products.
Ne samo što znat, toku I redovno go pijat češko to pivo na nivno golema zadovoljstva. Koji drugi izumi i inovacije češka gidarila na svetot, a sepak ne se toliko mnogo poznati vo javnosti?
Again, it would be a quite a long list, and I have to say that it wouldn't be just for the Czech Republic, but for the Czechoslovakia as such. I might mention, for example, what people might don't know, that the blood groups were identified by the Czech inventor, chemical polygraphy, that was invented by Professor Hayrovsky, who's been awarded by the Nobel Prize for in chemistry for this invention. But there will be lots more. I can for example mention the outstanding job that's been done by Professor Holly, who has invented antiviruses that are used as drugs against, for example, AIDS and hepatitis B, and lots of others. For example, from the modern time, I would say that there was a very well admitted invention, which is controlling the computers by the eye motion, that was invented in the Czech Republic recently. Among others, I might mention, for example, the contact lenses that were invented by the Czech inventor Otto Wichterle. And just for fun, the sugar cubes came and were done for the first time in Czechoslovakia also.
Кога станува збор за вака значајна ретроспектива, секако е мощно значајно да ги подсетиме нашите гледачи и на интернационално познатите личности од вашата земја.
It's not easy because you cannot name all, but just to give some small examples, I would start with some writers, let's say. People probably know Karel Čapek, who introduced for the first time the word robot, or Franz Kafka, who's been very well known, maybe for those who like lighter materials, Jaroslav Hašek and his The Good Soldier Schweik, describing all the absurdities within the wars that are in the world. And also, I cannot forget the first democratic president, Václav Havel, who was a poet and playwright before he became very popular president of the Czechoslovakia and then Czech Republic. I might be mentioning also the film director Miloš Forman, who unfortunately passed away quite recently, who was awarded twice by the Oscar for his two films, One Flight Over the Cuckoo's Nest and Amadeus, for example. And there are also many others from other type of professional jobs. I might be mentioning some well-known sport persons that are on the Czech or Czechoslovak origin. The football players Masopust or Nedvěd, or Emil Zátopek, Železný, Ivan Lendl as a tennis player, or Jaromír Jágr, who is very known for our young generation as the famous hockey player. And of course, to get to more serious group of people, I think that everybody knows Czech and Czechoslovak composers, Bedřich Smetana, Antonín Dvořák, Leoš Janáček, Oldřich Martin and the others. So those are really, you know, long list that I would be able to name, but I think those are the main.
Bedřich Smetana je jedno od onih imenja koje je popularno vo cijeli od sveta, no i v Makedonija, za koje je Franz Liszt ima kažano deka je genijalan muzički tvorec so Božjo srce. No, pomalko je poznato deka to je roden vo renesansni od zamok vo Litomišo, vo istoimeni od grad vo Češkata Republika i deka za imenjata kako što je Mavest, Mojata Tatkovina i Voltava se krije v sušnost se krijat kompozicijite, šest kompoziciji posvetenje na vašta tatkovina i kompozicijata Voltava posvetena na najdolgata reka vo Češkata Republika. I sigurna sam deka sega našite gledači će uživat vo sve to na što će go vidat kada je toj roden i vo muzikata koja što ušte jednaš će ji ispolni nivnite srca. Voltava. Kulturnata sorabotka svekogaš go privlekuva interesot na poširokiot auditorijom. Vi imate isto taka prekrasni projekt i nastani manifestaciji na ovoj plan. Vi molam, spodelete nekoj od njih za našte gledači.
For example, we can see lots of translation of books, of the Czech books, into the Macedonian language recently. And I would like to point out at least two of those, because they are quite important. One is the history of the Czech Republic, and the other one is through the Czech culture. And other things I might be mentioning, for example, the exhibition that we had in the evening before the celebration of Cyril and Methodius in March this year, when we participated on the postmark exhibition connected with those two persons, and after that the film about Cyril and Methodius shot by the Czech director was played for the people, so that was another interesting event. And as you personally know, the Czech embassy tries to be as supportive as possible and participate every year on the festival Bogorodic and Pokrov.
Dozvolite vo ime na moj suprug gospodin Kole Jovanovski, televizijski montažer i režiser, i vo moje lično ime kako osnovači na Međunarodni filmski festival za kulturni, duhovni i humani vrednosti, da se zablagodaram na Češki od narod, na vaša ta ambasada, na vas lično gospodine Toman, na Češkata nacionalna televizija i posebno na gospodinu Djožev Brož, zamenik ambasador vo амбасадата на Чешката република тука во Скопје за големата поддршка за вака возвишените вредности која вие ја давате цело време од основањето на овој фестивал и за која Чешката амбасада се стекна во два наврати со диплома на духовни и хумани вредности на свечаното отворање на фестивалот.
Yes, for example, for the first year of the festival, we were able to get not only the film Jan Hus, that was directed by Jiří Svoboda, but we also managed to get him as a guest to the festival, and since he's been the chairman of the European Film Academy, I think that we can contribute with such a people for the next years also.
Да подсетиме дека беа и други видни гости од вашата цената држава, меѓу кои и господинот Виктор Криштоф, кој што е многу познат холивудски чешки продуцент и кој ништо ни се представи со филмот посветен на светите Кирил и Метод, играниот филм со кој што беше одушевена нашата публика. Исто така, со филм посветен на свети Кирил и Метод беа присутни и авторите на филмовите Јана Студничкова и Отокар Марија Шмид. Така да ние сме пресретни што имавме толку многу прекрасни гости од вашата држава. Повикувајќи ги гледачите на третото издание на фестивалот за културни, духовни и хумани вредности Богородичен покров, кој ќе почне на 14 октомври. Јас би сакала да споделам уште една нова информација дека изложбата која беше минатата година врзана со духовното наследство на Македонија од вашиот господин заменик амбасадор господинот Брошко е и фотограф аматер ќе биде презентирана токму во православната црква во Прага посветена која исто така на големите светители свети Кирил и Методи и за се тоа морам секако повторно вас да ви заблагодарам.
Мирослав Хавел, поранешен председател на Република Чешка, изјавил: „Ова е најдобриот документарец кој некогаш сум го гледал.“
This old man saved my life and that of hundreds of others in the Second World War.
There were thousands of children on the lists who wanted to get out.
Then the day came that we had to leave.
Со кои манифестации годинава ќе го одбележите овој голем јубилеј, 100 години од основањето на Чехословачка и за кој повод ние сега денес говориме?
Yes, you know, 100 years anniversary is quite different from the others. I mentioned that we are going to celebrate together with our Slovak colleagues and brothers. So we have tried to prepare more than usual, and of course you would be happy if everything goes well. For the beginning, we are organizing the exhibition of the Batya shoe company and how it went, how it goes through the history. It's going to happen sometime in September, and that will be a kickoff of the events that we are preparing for the celebration. Then we would like to participate at Bogorogichi and Pokrov Festival. The other day, on the October 16th, we have the official reception together with our Slovak colleagues. We will be celebrating in the Macedonian Philharmonic. For that, we have invited a duet, one Czech guy and a Slovak lady that will be having concert before the official reception, and I hope it will be a nice cultural event for all the participants. Then after that, we plan to have a concert, a piano concert, as a part of the Roma Festival that is organized by the time in Skopje. And last but not least, we would definitely like to show some arts pictures that been devoted and donated to Macedonia and Skopje itself after the earthquake in 1963 in the Museum of Contemporary Art in Skopje. There are like 250 arts from the Czech artists and about up to 50 of Slovaks. So for the first time, if I'm not mistaken, we would like to do the exhibition of those arts in the Museum of Contemporary Art, and we hope that it will be a great possibility to see actually those artists that were quite young during the time of that event, and how they grew up during the times, and we might see very well-known artists right now that send their arts more than 40 years ago to Skopje when they started their job.
Gospodine ambasadore, pred da go završim razgovorot, bi vas zamolila da progovorite malo za vašite celi, za vašite prioriteti vo domenu na idната соработка со Македонија. Како што е познато, вие го започнавте мандатот минатата година. Што ќе биде вашиот приоритет во наредниот период?
Yes, I haven't mentioned yet that Czech Republic has recognized Macedonia in 1994 as the 20th state in the world, and since then we have very good relations. We don't have any open issue between our two countries. So I have lots of to follow and to fill up the shoes that you know my predecessor were using before me. But anyway, I have some ideas what I would like to do during the time that I will stay in Macedonia. First of all, I have mentioned already that the Czech Republic has supported and is supporting and will be supporting Macedonia on the way to the Euro-Atlantic organizations. And this is something I think that we can help and be of your help, because we did the same a couple of years ago, so our experience from the accession talks, from the meeting, for example, NATO standards, might be used by your authorities, by your people, and we would very much like to be helpful in that transition time. And if there will be the interest on the Macedonian side, we will definitely be trying to help and to give you our experience from that time when we were in the position that you are right now. Other things that I have in mind is, of course, to higher the awareness here in Macedonia about the Czech Republic, Czech people, but also in the Czech Republic about Macedonia and Macedonian people. I have mentioned that we managed to get some financing for the university and for the lectors to allow them to teach the Czech language. So I hope that we will see in the future more and more people being interested in going to the Czech Republic, studying the Czech language. And on the other side, I would also like to see more Czechs coming over and bringing, you know, more tourists. Our idea is to cooperate on that with the institution which is called Macedonia Timeless, and to bring more tourists, to bring more students, to bring more young people, to bring more culture event, and to do some exchange between our two countries, and hope I and my colleagues at the embassy will be successful in that. What I would definitely like to see more developing is the area of the economical cooperation that I mentioned, that we don't have too much robust right now. So we will continue in promoting Czech companies, Czech business. We will be trying to get more representatives of Czech industry, Czech businesses to Macedonia and vice versa, to bring people from Macedonia to the Czech Republic for some fair trades and stuff like that. So the awareness of the people of both countries, it's much higher than it's now. And last but not least, we will definitely continue in supporting schools, scholarships, stipendiums, because I think that when we, whatever we do for the young people, it will come back in the future to all of us, and it's something that I would like to build a solid base for now and for the future, so the young people might be together, hopefully within the EU, within the NATO, and just be part of the Europe. So this is my goal, those are my priorities, and of course there are lots of more, but it will come later, and I hope that Czech Republic and Czech Embassy is not going to disappear from Macedonia for a long, long time.
Děkuji.
Благодарю.